This clip's made possible by Sovranti. More about them at the end of the show. Hey, it's Chris from the Charity Board Gamer, and guess what? Today is Punchable Monday, and today we're going to go ahead and take a look on the inside of Nia the Ninja from Brotherwise Games and Processing from Fight in a Box. Let's dive in. So, disclaimer, as soon as Nia the Ninja came in, I had to open it, so I did, and I played it already. And it's that good enough that I do want to show what's on the inside. Some of the pieces have already been punched because, well, I wanted to play the game. So yeah, the rule books, nice stuff, a little artwork, a little strategy, facts to it. All right, here we go. So you got all these little boards right here. These are actually, this is really cool. So this plays up to 11 players. And you can have a character like the Ronin character. You can have these Lotuses, and I forget, I think it's the Cranes is the other group. But on these little player boards, they're stand up. And this is really neat. So check this out. You got this little stand up right here. And when you get killed, you tip it over. You're dead. Plain and simple. Can't be playing any of those other cards either, which is really neat. So you got these little things right here, little stand ups for everybody. You got the little stand up pieces. And then, of course, you've got these cards right here, which are cards that you will be using throughout the game, kind of using a drafting mechanism where you'll draft out of three cards. You'll take two, you'll keep them, and you'll play them during different phases. And what's nice is that on these little player things, it tells you the phases in order. Genius already. I mean, I'm really impressed with what Brotherwise did just on that basis alone. Because if you're playing a game like Werewolf, or you're playing something that's social deduction-wise, you don't always know who's goes next or who goes when. So that's kind of a big thing. So then on these, you've got all the cards of the different characters. So you've got the Lotus, you've got the Cranes, you've got the Ronin. The Ronin's considered the wild card in the game. When we play this Thursday, we're going to go ahead and we're going to play with the Ronin, three Crane, and three Lotus. So yeah, we are getting ready for that this Thursday on our live stream. So we'd love for you to check that out. So that is Nia Ninja. What's in here? These are honor tokens. They have values of 2 to 4. So they look like little ninja stars. So see that right there? Ninja stars right there. And they've got little values and scores up there and everything like that. So this one's worth 4 points. First one to get to 10 wins. Very simple. A lot of fun though. Love this game. I'll be doing a little how to play of it, or kind of like a how does it work Wednesday on this one soon. So let's put that away. All right, next one is Processing. This is from Fight in a Box. This is Seppi Yoon. So I have not played this. Seppi gave it to me at one of the conventions recently. I think it was Origins. And so this is supposed to be like a social deduction game. I don't know much about it. I don't know how it plays. But we're going to be playing it. So let's go ahead. Got like these little pieces here. They look like almost detectives and cows and all that stuff. But we got some punchables, so let's punch. And then we got this little board. So I'm guessing this board plays a factor in everything. Don't know what. There's a long board. And there's a cow board. Well, I'm guessing it's had something to being abducted by aliens. Not sure about the cows. But maybe we're like cows and humans going up against each other. Not sure. Let me open up the cards though. Let's take a look at those. So this game came out, I think it was what, 2020 is what it was originally scheduled. But of course, if nobody knows, there's a pandemic. So it's kind of hard to play social deduction games with large parties. But this one has some neat little cards. You got deranged humans, utterly nutsoids. I'm guessing those are aliens. Cow servants, toy bots, tentacle beast, body snatchers, classy gray UFOs, gray anarchists, missionarians. It looks like somebody in the church coming to your house to make, I don't know. That's just weird. Minotaurians, tardigrades, vegantars, psy cows, sympathetics, fluffies, space clowns, Fabuluxians. What in the world, Seppi, did you send me home with? Okay, and then it looks like these are like, I have no clue what these cards are about. So, yeah, I have no clue. This is one of those ones where I'm going to be checking out. Look, hi, hello, my name is Steffi. And Free, hello, my name is Charles White. Hello, my name is Dekarnix, or Misha. Oh, look, you can get probed in this game. Cassian Gray, Prisoner A451. And, ooh, you can process somebody. So, no clue how this is going to play. I'm very curious. What's nice about this is I noticed that there's this large bag, of course, with all of the wooden pieces, the little cows, and the humans. And then, here's all the punchables. So, it is Punchable Monday. Let's punch them. Oh, nice. These are like the ones that don't have anything in between them, so it's just easy to just kind of pull them out. So, all these weird little tokens. I don't know what all they are. There's these blue tokens. I am really going to be confused about this game until I read the rules. All right, let's see here. These are like little pieces of ham. I'm guessing that these little tokens have something to do with the words processing and all that stuff. So, not sure. Then you got plus 10 points. I'm guessing this is scoring for a deduction game of some sort. There must be something. It's called a game of serving humanity. So I wonder if people are eating humans. Now that would be kind of interesting to see. So here we go. More punching, more punching, more punching, more punching, more punching, more punching, more punching. Bloop. And more punching, more punching, more punching. Processing. Probing. Blue card token things. There's a lot more blue. So I'm guessing that these are going to come in more play often in the game. So there we go. All right. Now the fun part. Banging it all up. I know what you're thinking. What are those tokens for? My answer for you. I have no freaking clue. All right. Let's keep getting these put away. All right. There we go. There we go. There we go. No! Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom. All right. Put those away. And that, folks, is processing. We're going to find out more about that one also this week when we play it live. We're going to be playing that with a party of, three to six players. So, guess we'll be playing it with six. That's processing. So, that is your Punchable Monday, folks. We went ahead and we took a look inside of Night of the Ninja and processing. We'll see you next week. Have an amazing Monday. Bye. Hey, do you guys want to play Isle of Cats?
No.
Luckily, there's a new way of being able to play online and virtually, and that is Sovranti's platform. Sovranti has a bunch of different games that you can play fully scripted. So you can play Isle of Cats, you can play Skull King, you can play just a multitude of games thanks to the different publishers that have worked with them. And perfect example, here I am playing Isle of Cats. This is actually on my Pixel 3 phone playing it. And you can actually play this on Android, iOS, or on your PC using the special promo code, the CBG, and try 60 days free of their Platinum service. Hope you enjoy it.
Hey, thanks for watching our video.
If you like what you saw here, go ahead and hit that little like, subscribe, that little bell thingamabobber-obber, you know the thing. And watch some of our videos, maybe one that's maybe up here, or maybe down there, or over there, or down there. I don't know where they are, but thank you all. Remember, when we can gather at the table, we can do the same for a good cause. Bye.
Bye.